And now get ready because you are about to meet 14 authors who have done exactly what Lacey has done. And these are authors who, some of them, I think five of the authors you'll meet today are actually sharing their second books, most of them their second book within a year. So what is possible when you are really committed to making the difference you were born to make? And somebody who over the last year has done a lot of that is two-time number one international best-selling author Sophia Rimaldi. Sophia, come on out here, kick us off on the red carpet. Hello. So I'm so excited about your second book. Your first book was called Phase Out. The new book is called Level Up: Powerful Practices for Spiritual Superabundance. Getting two bestsellers out in a year is definitely some spiritual superabundance. So hit us with it. How do we do it? How do we level up?
Well, it all started for me when I actually felt like I was at the apex of my career as a performing artist. I was in Tokyo in Japan. I was asked to go over to Dance with Robots, which was like my dream job. Sounds really cool, right? But it was actually a version of success that was given to me outside of myself. It wasn't what I really wanted to be doing. And so when I realized that, my life fell apart. Everything fell apart.
Great. Are you
Right?
recommending this approach?
Sort of.
Yeah.
Because what happened was I ended up going on a pilgrimage that changed my life forever because I realized that reality is not actually what it seems, and we can actually create the world that we want to see. And so you don't have to go through that whole part where it all falls apart because there's paths and there's ways to just start doing the thing that you really want to be doing in your soul and creating the world that you want to see right now.
And I know you kind of recreate some of those opportunities from your long falling apart adventure by taking people on pilgrimages. Can you share a little about that?
Yeah, so I work with creative people who are having a spiritual awakening. I know y'all are out there, right? Doing the yoga, doing the meditation, and opening your minds. And if that's you, really, I believe that you're a creative visionary, right? That you have that power in you. What you see is actually what the world needs right now, right? And so to go through this process, to go on a pilgrimage is the fastest act of transformation I've ever experienced. You get to go through the whole hero's journey, and that to me is what leveling up is. It's going through all of the things that make you you, bringing them together, and then uplifting and upleveling and stepping into the role that only you are meant for.
So I want to ask for one, because I know crazy things happen on these pilgrimages. So I have one in mind, but I won't plant it. Maybe I'll do it telepathically. Sometimes we communicate that way. But on one of your pilgrimages, for you or for one of your clients who've been on one of your pilgrims, what is like one miracle that you've seen happen in person on a pilgrimage?
I want to know what yours
The one
is.
with the allergy.
Yeah.
Yeah. I love that story.
So one of my clients on a pilgrimage came and is an amazing person. Now is doing amazing work. She helps women feel great in their bodies, look great, and love their bodies. But she does it in a really unconventional way. Her name is Jessica Brown White. She's amazing.
Hello.
And she runs BIO, which means Body Image Object. And so she helps women through coaching and through healing and through artistic practice in order to overcome their obstacles, step into their whole being. And what they get in the end is this individualized art object that's a ritual art object that's casted from their body. But here's the thing, is that before the pilgrimage, Jessie had some things going on, and in particular, one of them was severe allergies, like to shellfish and to peppers. And I know
I
it's
have a pepper allergy.
close
That's
to
why I love this story.
severe, like needed to carry an EpiPen because her throat would close up and she wouldn't be able to breathe and possibly had to go to the hospital. So while we're in Mexico, you know, it's Mexico, and there was all kinds of peppers everywhere. And she was like, "Oh, I just want to eat the peppers." And we said, "Well, why can't you eat the peppers?" And she's been working with me for a while, so she knows that when you use your mind, you can heal your bodies and your lives and everything. And so by the end of Tulum, we were doing all kinds of healings and all kinds of rituals. So by the end, Jessie was eating the mole, loving it. We were shouting ole.
No one was going to the
No
hospital.
one went to, she was totally fine. But it took really getting in there and healing what had been a deep disconnect from her creative capacity and ability to really create change in the world.
That's what I love about the story, because the allergy is just like secondary. I mean, it's nice to get rid of an allergy because it is a pain in the neck, especially with Mexican food. But more than that, it's like, what was that allergy doing to keep you from leveling up?
Exactly.
two books in 1 year. I have to ask you, people out there are wondering, what is something that you have learned from being an incubated author, spending the year getting these books out? What's one tip or piece of advice that you'd love to pass on to somebody who's thinking about writing a book?
The one thing I have to say to you is that truly we only have right now. Like, this moment right now is actually the only thing that really exists. And you infuse that into all the work that you do with all of us, really and truly. And so to me, that means two things. It means if you want to write a book, do it now. Right? Like, not later, not tomorrow. There's no such thing, right? Do it now. And the other part of that is really, like, through your process. I mean, I wrote my one book in 3 days. The second one, I wrote it in 4, but I had to get oral surgery in the middle. Right. And I still did it, right?
4 with a tooth extraction.
Right. And I took an extra day. But it's that feeling of urgency and that knowing that truly, 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 like, now's all we have, so why not just do it now? And your process really allows us to create the container so that the now, it happens so fast.
Yeah, that is definitely the miracle of leveling up, and I just force people into leveling up. She does it a little more elegantly and with more beautiful locations. And what a beautiful cover. This is Level Up, Power Practices for Spiritual Superabundance. It is on Amazon right now for free, limited time. Link going up online. You call them creative visionaries. Do you love a creative visionary? Maybe it's your sister. Maybe it is a very good friend. Maybe it's your mom. Who knows? But if there is a creative visionary in your life, I want you to do two things. One, download the book, because we should all always be leveling up wherever you are. But if there's someone who comes to mind when you see this cover, you see Sophia, and you know you need to share it, this is that extra nudge. Take that link, share it with a friend right now while you're downloading it. Sophia, congratulations on book number 2. Thanks for kicking us off.
Thank you so much.